All right, what's up, guys? Got a really exciting episode for you. We just got our clan chest, and I want to open it up, but there's so much that happened yesterday for me to get it. I just want to go through all of that, and then we're going to open it up. Today, it's going to be a fairly longer video, but I figure, you know, if some of you guys like spend like half of the day or maybe the whole day playing Clash Royale, I think it would be okay if you watched my video for like 20, 25 minutes. Now, I do have snacks for today's video. Today we got some mini bananas. They're actually really tasty. Then, of course, I got chestnuts. It's like you just open them up like this. And then you pop one out. See? These are chestnuts. So basically, really, really tasty. And then, of course, I got a cup of water. And I got a cup of milk. Now you're saying like, Alex, why do you have a cup of milk? Well, because it's like when you talk a lot, you know, your mouth gets really dry. And you would think that the water would help, but it doesn't. Because it just, you basically, when you drink water, like I don't know why this is a biology class, but when you drink water, you swallow the saliva. But with milk, you kind of produce saliva so you don't dry out as fast. That makes sense. Well, anyway, so this is the clan. I had a whole bunch of people help me out get here. So what we're going to do is we're going to go through my gameplays, and you guys are going to see me opening up two epic chests. You're going to see me opening up maybe several, like three or four free chests. Then we're going to have two or three crown chests. Then we're going to open up a classic challenge chest. We're going to open up a tourney chest. And then my friend Blue from RoyalSavagesz sent me his mega chest opening video. It's gonna be a giant chest, a super magical chest, a legendary chest, and then he opens up a 12 elixir draft challenge chest, which I also have one, so you get two of those. So we got like, I don't know, like maybe 10, 15 chests you guys are gonna see. So let's get into it. So this is the free chest that I got last week. I got like two free legendaries. I got a Lava Hound, which was brand new on my main account, which has like 3,000 trophies. And then I got that log, which was like a big surprise. So I've got into a knack of recording free chest openings. So here we got one. We got some gems here. We got an elixir pump. Now, this had three. You notice it had three, so it didn't have any legendaries or any epics, but it was a good chest to open nonetheless. So here we're going to go into it's going to be, we're going to see a lot of, like, fresh videos, like, coming out of nowhere. So hopefully that's going to just make sense throughout the video eventually. So over here we got a crown chest. Now, on this account, I do have a lot of gold. I have a lot of gems. And that's the account that I want to play Grand Challenges on eventually, as things kind of slowed down. I don't know, like last week, everything was really hectic in Clash Royale for me. I don't know why, but I think I'm kind of coming through with the terms that I need to start getting to push trophies again. Like, it was really tough to get to 3,000, so I got really discouraged during the time. But I think now summer's picking up. You know, I want to go and do something more fun with the game. I might do some street gameplays. That's going to be really cool. So if you guys want, just subscribe to my channel. I'll be putting those videos out as soon as it warms up here with some of my clanmates. So we got a silver chest. Not a lot happening here. Although I did get a legendary out of a silver chest as well, incidentally a Lava Hound, which was in the shop. I didn't buy it because I'm not really a Lava Hound player. I like to stick into low elixir decks, but I think Lava Hound decks, if you play them right, man, you can get 300-400 trophies a day. I mean, those are really, really strong decks. So over here, I donated almost 10,000 cards. So Supercell gave me 50 gems. So that's going to help me get into tourneys and stuff like that. At this point, we're going to open up another crown chest. What I've been doing also is I've been playing a lot of classic challenges. And the reason I play those classing challenges is because I don't want to push in a ladder to get chests. I feel like a big portion of this game is to get chests, but I noticed if you play classic challenges or if you play grand challenges, they give you crown chest cups. So that's what I've been doing. That's why I've been kind of motivated to play classic challenges, because they're cheap, you know, they're fun. But unfortunately, you have to get at least 10, 12 wins to even get a legendary. With a grand challenge, you could win like one or two and you can get a legendary. But with a classic challenge, you have to get at least 11 or 12. You could get a legendary, but it's like a 2% chance. It's like a very small chance. It's almost as much as you getting a legendary at a free chest that you can get a legendary out of a classic chest. So not too bad, you know. So this is the this is the draft challenge chest. I opened it in my previous video, but I figured it kind of belongs here more. So I keep saying grand challenge because it's like 12 wins over there. But this was the 2x elixir challenge, which was the rewards were gold. So if you won, if you got 12 wins, you got at least 135k gold. If you got 2 or 3 wins, I think it was like 4,000 gold, 6,000, and it went even in 2,000 increments, kind of doubling as it went. So I didn't get any legendaries here, but I did get a clone, which was, it's pretty cool. This is a fun card. So now this is from 5 Bluemon. He is him and Juan and a whole bunch of other guys I met on Facebook. So I don't know these guys in person, but there's a lot of communication. And so he was like, "Hey, Alex, you have a channel. So why don't you feature this on your channel?" So this is all of his chests. Now his clan is RoyalSavagesz, and the main reason I got my clan battle chest, is because a lot of his clanmates came into my clan and helped out. In addition to that, also ClashofPenrhynZ, Ned, a few of his guys came in. Also, my buddy Rashids came in. AK came in. Maori, like a lot of guys came in to help out because my clanmates, like a lot of them. I know everybody's busy with stuff, but a lot of them are not active on Clash Royale during the day as I am. They're usually active after work, or they're active on the weekends. So it doesn't really help for me to get the clan chest. Like we haven't been getting them in like maybe 2 or 3 weeks now. Like, we got them the first time when my clan filled up. But then after that, we just stopped getting them. I don't know why. Right now we got it, and we're going to open it up at the end of the episode. And as soon as we see some of these chest openings and 2 or 5 game replays, which were just clutch, we have to see them. So this is a Blue's chest. He got giant skellies out of that. And he got times 80 Goblin Gang. I don't know if he uses those, but I like those cards. So far we saw him open up a clan chest, a 12x elixir chest. Now he's going to go with a silver chest. The funny stuff here is he had a legendary chest there, but he accidentally opened it and he got a ice wizard out of that, which is his mascot. So now we got the 197 knights. My good, that's like you can upgrade it twice if you're lower arenas. So you got a 20 rage and he got a log, which is a really, really good card. But I think log, you know, it's like log is good when you first unlock it, but then to get it to level 3 or 4, it's not as exciting to keep getting it. I mean, that's my opinion, but Blue is also at 4,000 trophies. So if he pushes to 5,000, he can actually come out across a max princess, which even a level 2 or 3 log won't kill a princess. So here's some gold. We got 2,000 gold. We got one executioner, 33 heal cards, and a 294 minion horde, which is a lot of cards. That's actually a really, really good chest. So now he's going to open up his legendary chest. He said he has to make up for him accidentally opening up the chest that was for free. So he paid 500 gems, and which was pretty cool. And I'm pretty sure a lot of those gems I think he got from silver chests. I don't think Blue plays in Grand Challenges. If I'm not mistaken, I don't think he plays in Grand Challenges. All right, so that was all of his chests. I'll leave some of his clan info below. Be sure to check that out. So over here, we're going to watch three Classic Challenge replays. Now, what I noticed in Classic Challenge replays, it's like I haven't been doing a lot of Grand Challenges, and I want to. But I haven't had it in me to dedicate 100 gems to, I mean, I don't know if I can get past 6 wins. Like, I play well, but I guess I just haven't had the courage to go into it. And I will eventually. So I've been doing a lot of Classic Challenges. But what I notice is there's trophy players that are 3,400, 4,000 trophy players in these Classic Challenges that I actually beat. And this guy, I think he was at 3,200 trophies. So 3,200 trophies. And I was really surprised that I beat him because I just crossed into Hog Mountain. And I have been playing for a long time, but I haven't like had the same level of cards as some of the people that I played with. So what I mean to say with that is it's like, level cards are a big deal here. And because in Classic Challenges you get the same level cards, your strategy really comes out. And the deck that I'm playing is a Goblin Barrel Princess deck. Like some people said it's a log bait deck. And I think when I first started playing it, I didn't really realize it was log bait. But then as I started playing it, I was like, yo, this feels a little baity because you put the princess down, they log it, and then you throw the barrel, and they're like, they don't have a log for that. And if they have arrows or zap, then you send the goblin gang in. And then I was like, yo, I think I'm playing a log bait deck. But I really liked it because I first got offended that somebody said it's a log bait deck because, yo, man, I'm not baiting people. Like, this is like a legit strategy deck. And it is because it's a 3.3 deck, and it's not very easy to play. It's not very easy to play. You really have to, because the cards are not very strong, and you really have to pressure the person in Elixir. In addition to that, you also have to play strategy, right? If like a person sends a giant skeleton, you have to play a knight and an ice spirit, right? Because the giant skeleton in the Classic Challenge will kill the knight on its own. It's gonna win the duel, so you freeze it with the fire spirit. And it can you get a one advantage elixir on top of you being a really low deck. Now this battle was really really strong. I only got lucky towards the last minute, and he was at 22, and then I just rocketed him for the win, which was perfect. It was clutch, and I think he threw an angry emote after that, but it didn't really catch it in replay, which is fine. So this deck is 3.3. It's a Princess Barrel deck. It got me into a Hog Mountain. And I'll leave, like, I guess a screenshot or something. Oh, well, there it is. That's the screenshot there. It's a Rocket, Princess, Knight, Inferno Tower, Log, Goblin Barrel, of course, and Goblin Gang, which just, it's a really good card. It's a very, very good card. So here is this guy. He's 3,200. So he's about 4 wins higher than I am, so he's like 100 trophies more than I am. So we're gonna go in another battle with him. Now he's playing a Golem deck. Golem decks are a little bit easy to beat. Usually people that carry Golem decks, like with the deck that I run, Golem decks usually if they carry a Zap or a Lightning, it's gonna be really tough for me. But if they carry a Lightning and a Wizard, I usually don't win those. I haven't had enough experience to play against these guys. But usually what they do is they put a Golem and then they Lightning the Inferno. And if you see how I'm placing it right now, I kind of lucked out that he just had a minion horde. So I was able to counter that with my Princess. You see, it does so much damage because it has Splash. And so that means it hits everything in air and ground at the same time. So you see, we countered the Golem perfectly. Ideally, the way I play Golem is you see a golem, and as soon as it crosses the bridge, I send in my ice spirit. So that what that does is it slows down the golem, and it doesn't do any death damage to my Inferno Tower. So that's very important that at least you have to strategize like that. So now the guy who I learned this deck from, Rashid, he actually does the same play too. He actually does the same. Now you see me rocketing some barbs over there, which was, it feels good to do that. It feels really good. And it's an even elixir change. It's 6 for 6. If somebody was saying if Rocket was 5 elixir, what would that do? Well, that would give me a positive elixir change. And on top of it, you know how some people like cluster spawn everything at the bridge? Man, sometimes when you throw a rocket there, that's like, if they're doing a long push, like a big push from the back, that's like sometimes 11 elixir right away for 6. So it's an amazing advantage. So now look at my deck. This guy pushes Golem, and I just play Princess, but I already catch up really quickly. So he puts in, I decided to put my Inferno Tower at the front of my tower this time, because I wasn't sure what he was going to put over the bridge, you see. So that kind of prevented him from playing Minion Horde. Now, at the time, I didn't know that that was the case, that he didn't have Minion Horde, but now looking at the map, you can see that he doesn't have it. So he gets my tower. He gets my tower. I'm not worried because I know that that will, I can do a rocket or something like that. Now, he rushed it with the princess there because he, I don't know why he put a princess there. This guy's 3,200 trophies, so you could still see some inexperience. Like, I'm not so experienced, but you can see some inexperience from even higher arena players. The next gameplay that you guys are going to see, the guy was 3,500. He was 3,500 trophies, and big surprise, I beat him. So we're gonna check that out. I think I'm going to go into one of my snacks here while this game is finishing up. I don't know if you guys seen these. These are Ecuador baby bananas. Now these are like really sweet, really tasty bananas. I don't know how you guys open these. Oh man, they're kind of hard to open because they have like a really thin skin. So here we go. Look at this. I'm like freaking Donkey Kong. You guys remember that game, Donkey Kong? Check this out. Yo, I opened it just like Donkey Kong. Jeez. So this is the banana. I know you've seen a banana, but see, it's different. It's small. And it's very sweet. It's like, I don't know if you ever had dried bananas, but they taste really, really good dried because all of the sugars and all the flavors are condensed and they're not like diluted by water. So this is what we got here. It's very, you gotta try them, baby bananas. So here we go, we just got that guy. Zavi from Almighty Reborn. He was a good sport, actually. He didn't BM or anything like that. So he was a really good sport. Now this guy is Alvaro845 YouTube. Now I don't know if this was the actual YouTuber. The real YouTuber, Alvaro, he plays Clash Royale, but he has more subs than like all of the people that we watch. He has like almost 3 million subscribers, guys. So this guy is as big as S-Sundy, and PewDiePie, of course, has like 50 million subs. But I thought that that was him. So I'm not sure if it's not. It could be like one of his fans. But this guy is at 3,500 trophies. And this was probably the tightest game that I played. It literally went down to just two digit HP on who was going to win the match. So he has some really good manners. He didn't BM. He did get a little bit pissed off at the end when I won. But I mean, I don't blame him. So now, Ice Wizard for Princess is a bad is a bad counter because Ice Wizard for Goblin Barrel is also a bad counter because Ice Wizard doesn't really kill. He slows it down, and it takes him almost 2 to 3 extra hits to take down a goblin. So if you have a Goblin Barrel, he's not going to be. He's a very poor counter. Your tower will go down almost as much as it would if there was nothing countering it. It goes down a lot. So he put a princess, and that gave me a good advantage there on his right tower. So we took him down a lot. So he has an Inferno Tower too, which if they have a if they have a hog and they have an Inferno Tower, I don't enjoy those decks. I don't enjoy those decks because they, I can't throw anything. Like, I can't put a Goblin Gang down. I can't put a Princess down. If I send in my Knight, it gets annihilated. So I have to just Rocket Cycle. I have to Rocket Cycle those. And that's not fun. Rocket Cycling is not very fun. Now, he's sitting on full Elixir, so he throws down a Valk. And then he does a Pig Push on the left. That's a Hog Push. Put like Ice Spear or something. But he's using a Wizard. So I don't know what, you know, whatever. He has some good games. I mean, I saw some mistakes. But now we have his right tower at almost 1500. He's trying to go for my left tower because it has just the most damage. I wouldn't do that. I mean, just because the other tower is 200 points less doesn't mean that that's the tower you should go for. I would defend his lower tower and then do counter pushes. Like, that's what I would do. I mean, that's me. But it's very hard to think in a tourney and in a classic challenge when you know there's a lot of pressure there, because if you have 3 wins, that's it, you're out of the game. So I can understand, I think, where he was making some of the mistakes. So my Princess is just doing work on the right side. He's throwing a well played. I throw in my Goblin Gang and he had nothing to counter. So he threw some angry emotes there. He's getting a little bit pissed. So now we're in rocket range. All I had to do was just throw a rocket there, and that gave me the win. And he threw a well played. He was a very good sport. I said good luck just not to be nice. I mean, it wasn't luck. It wasn't luck. I mean, I won it fair and square. He didn't have the cards. I mean, I don't know if you consider that luck. But here's us investigating his account. So it looks like it's in Spanish. He's from Europe. And Alvaro, I think, is in South America. Or maybe he's in Spain. I don't know. So we got 8 wins. And then I lost to somebody last night. And because I rushed one play, and that's it. The guy countered with a hog, and he got like 400 or 500 damage. So over here we get a tornado, which is not bad for 10 gems, and I think I got almost 1,000 gold out of that. Oh well, I got 880, but you want to get 1,000. You want to at least reach for 1,000, because then it makes sense. You gain a lot of like that. So here I bought these epic chests, but the video corrupted. So this is my second epic chest. We got 9 knights on that, 8 witches, which is really good. 8 witches is very good. So unfortunately the video corrupted. Now this was the championship tourney. I just played like a few matches. So we got a little chest. Some of my friends have been getting like second spots and first spots, and you can get a legendary in the second spot, and I didn't know that. Discord, we are on Discord for my clan, so you guys should check that out. Okay, so now we're finished with a lot of the chest openings. We are done with the classic tournament replays. If you guys got this far, I'll try to like lower the amount you have to keep watching. But I think this might be a really long video. So this is where it comes into, where a lot of guys came into my clan and we start playing. Now, Captain Clob, he is from RoyalSavagesz. Devil, he's from... Now, Maiori, he's from ClashofPenrhynZ. He is Neds' buddy. So we had a lot of guys from random clans that came in. You can see Captain Clob, he's a 4,000 trophy player, so really strong player. Him and I, we partnered up, and when he was helping out guys, he got like 11 trophy. Like, he was ranking number 5. And okay, so that was Netsky over there. He's also from a different clan, but he came in to help out. So I played with all of them. They all helped out. Some of them teamed up with each other, like from their own clans, and then they helped out. And thankfully, that still counts towards the clan chest. With regular clan chest, it doesn't count. You have to be in the clan. But in clan battles, that's why it's so good that you can just—it's unfiltered. You can play with anybody. So these are gonna be 3 quick replays, okay? Captain Claw pushes a Lava Hound, and he told me how to play it with him in partnership to support the deck that he has.
and vice versa. Like when if I would have a lava hound, he would, because the way the decks, the synergy worked, we would support each other like really, really well. So I start off with the lava hound, and then he pushes a balloon in the back, and that gives us some time for the mega minion to do some work on whatever comes. So we counter his giant very easily, which actually has very little HP in turny levels. So our balloon is gonna do a whole bunch of work. So now at this point he clones it, and that just pretty much just takes out the tower, which gets us a well played from the opponents. Well, we should see one eventually. So now we have a double Skarmy on the golem. And at this point, these guys are just kind of like, I don't think they know what's going on. They're like, oh man, this is some kind of pro duo that just went against us. So no fun. There is no fun for us here in this match. So we're waiting to fill up over here on Elixir. The good thing about the deck that we're running is it does have some expensive cards, but it has also some cheap cards for quick counters. So at this point, we just do another balloon push, Lava Hound balloon push. That kind of gets us stopped a little bit, but I freeze both of their towers, and so the Lava Pups do work. They do a lot of work. So those guys throw out some crying emojis. So thankfully, we had some counters here. If we weren't going to three crown them, it would have been fine if we just won just like with two towers, as long as we got some wins, because clan battle chest ends in like 8 hours, and we were kind of, I mean, I was kind of in a crunch too, because a lot of these guys went out of their way to help me out, so I kind of wanted to do just whatever. So now they cloned their e-giant there, and I forgot what we threw there, but we got that really well. So you see, we're still countering even though we have really expensive pushes. So at this point, we get another Lava Hound, and the balloon goes a different direction. So, and then we froze everything, and it just started doing a lot of work. And I think we're gonna see a clone here in a second, which is gonna completely shred everything. Oh man, look at that. That was a very clutch moment. They got a little bit angry, but I come across people that have some really interesting decks, like quad hogs, and then if they clone them, you get like 8 hogs, and you know, sometimes you just enjoy the game, you know, it's like, I mean, I'm not the one to talk because I've rage quit a lot, but at some point you really do have to just enjoy the game, because it's not gonna go very far for you to keep raging in this game. You're not gonna think straight. This game is strategy, and if the other person's taunts completely overwhelm you, it's best to just mute it. Like, you're not gonna, you know, it's not going to help you, is what I'm trying to say. So here on the right side, we have a really nice push going. There's a balloon. And the Ice Spirit didn't really help much. It seemed like it did for a little bit. But I froze early. I should have waited. I shouldn't have frozen, because I should have frozen when the tower went down. And then at this point, you see, nothing would have been attacking. So that was my mistake there, and it cost us one push. I mean, you see, the thing about Lava Hound players is you get impatient really fast, because you're so used to winning 3 crowns like that. You just think that, oh man, like, you see, like, look, their king tower's at 700, and I was already like, oh man, I was like ready to throw an angry emote, because I just, you know, we just didn't finish it that quickly. So we got another Lava Hound, and those guys are not—they don't have a really good defense. I think they were running maybe Hog decks or something by the cannon. So that actually is not really bad for my Lava Hound. That actually could counter it. So now,
all right. So we are recording. I think I do have some time on here. So we're getting a lot of gold here. We just got 1,000 gold for donating some of these epics. Now, the reason I buy epic chests is so I can, because I play Goblin Barrel, so I have to get those. If not, then because I'm clan leader, I can donate, which is really good. Okay, so let's get this chest. Now, I am hoping for a legendary, honestly any, but if I were to get one, it would probably be Bandit. So let's get into it. All right, so we got gold, 1620 gold. Now, I think you're supposed to get two rares or two epics. You're supposed to get three epics, and then you get a legendary. So we got 69 spear gobs. That's a lot, so that's good. So we got 80 archers. Epic. So that's a good start already, so that's one epic. Gen skeleton. All right, let's see. So we got three muskies. So we got a rare. So we got two epics. No, we got two commons. We got one epic. And then we got a rare. So there's more commons. Okay, we got heal. We got heal. Was I supposed to get another epic? Guys, I think it's just going to be two more epics. All right, let's see. Executioners, not bad. A lot of my clanmates want them. I really was hoping for a legendary, but look, I can't complain. This was a clan chest that we almost didn't see coming, and we got it. So I was very happy with that, and I'm just going to take a screenshot here for my story. So anyway, guys, I appreciate you watching. I appreciate all the help. Be sure to subscribe. I will be having a really, really fun street series that's going to be coming, where I actually go and I take this game and I interact with people. So it's going to be very fun, and I'm looking forward to it. I'm going to have a friend of mine from my clan help me out with this, and hopefully there'll be two, and then we're going to go out and film, and I can't wait for this series to come out, and I hope you guys enjoy it. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you could, please leave a big thumbs up for the chests that were donated and things like that, and I'll catch you in the next one.